What's going on, guys? It's MaxMax24. That Nintendo Direct, there was a lot going on. Let's talk about it. Before we get into it, please click that subscribe button, click that bell notification so you know when I upload. Share this with all your friends on Facebook, on whatever social media you use. Now let's talk about Nintendo. Nintendo Direct is the last press conference, but it's not a normal press conference, but it's better than a Square Enix press conference. It's straight to us, there's talking, and Reggie talks, and then there's some trailers, and it's very informative. They start off with this new game, Daemon X Machina. It's a robot game, a mech fighting game. Looked interesting, we don't know much about it, just a lot of mech fighting. Good way to start, I guess, and didn't really know anything about it. And then they went into talking about Fire Emblem, a new Fire Emblem game for Switch. I'm not a huge Fire Emblem fan. I played... What Fire Emblem did I play? I borrowed a Fire Emblem from a friend. I don't even remember which one it was. Played it for a little bit. Then I moved on. But for all you Fire Emblem fans, there's one coming for the Switch. It's called Three Houses. I hope you're excited. You probably are. Then, oh, the biggest news. Oh, wow. Everybody knew this was coming. Fortnite to Switch. Wow. I mean, I'm not gonna download it, but you guys can. I could care less. And then they talked about Octopath Traveler. It's an RPG, you guys probably know what it is. It's coming to Switch. So yeah, there you go. Play it. They shut off some more of Let's Go Pikachu and Let's Go Eevee. They look like fun. I mean, it's not a normal core RPG Pokemon game, but they are making a core RPG Pokemon game for next year. This is just a little thing to tie us over till then. It's like a combo of Pokemon Go and a Pokemon core RPG. It looks like a good time. I think I'm going to buy it. And they're going to sell so many of those Pokeball Plus things, and apparently Mew comes packaged with every single one. So, Mew's not going to be very rare after that, if everybody has it. But oh well. Then after that, finally, I've been waiting for this. They announced Super Mario Party. Every Nintendo console needs a Super Mario Party, a Mario Kart, a Legend of Zelda, and a Smash. If they have all four, it's a console that I want. And they announced Super Mario Party. Don't really know much about it yet, but it's Mario Party. It looks like you can connect multiple consoles. Like, they had this thing where they were playing a mini game and they put two consoles next to each other, like one above, and then one of the person's like, no, we don't like that. Then they changed it a little bit, so the entire like map of the mini game changed, so it played different. And it looked cool, you know, Switches working together. Playing Mario Party minigames is pretty genius. And then the big news came. Lots and lots about Super Smash Bros. Pretty much the rest of the conference was Super Smash Bros. This, Super Smash Bros. That, Super Smash Bros. Everything. Which, I like Super Smash Bros., but even that, after a while, it became a little much. But we got a title. It's called Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. It's a completely, entirely new title. It's not a port from the Wii U version or the 3DS version like everybody was afraid it was going to be. It's completely new. And it's got every single previous fighter. Every single one. That's a lot of fighters. Plus a few newcomers like the Inkling and Ridley. Yes, Ridley. The big meme on the internet. Ridley's in. And, I mean, I don't really care about Ridley, but I cared about the Inkling, because Splatoon 2 is a fun game, and I want to Splatoon Pikachu and Snake and everybody up. Yeah, Snake's coming back. So yeah, every single previous fighter. And they spent a lot of time showing all the little changes, all the little tweaks. Apparently, they redid Fox's and Falco's Final Smashes, and they just did a lot. There's no confirmation on a story mode. That'd be cool if there was. No confirmation. Then they also said that GameCube controllers will work for Smash Bros. Ultimate. So that's cool for all you people who still really like the GameCube controllers. I play with whatever controller the console has. I'm not picky like some of you people. And also, every amiibo is gonna work with Smash, so you can, you know, put your amiibo down, level it up, bring it to your friends. You got your leveled up character. Yeah. Most of it was spent about Smash. Then near the end, they revealed Xenoblade Chronicles 2 DLC. I don't have Xenoblade Chronicles, so I don't really care. But for all people who have Xenoblade Chronicles 2, they're making DLC. But other than that, it was mostly a Smash show, which was no surprise to me. Super Smash is their big, big project. There was no news about Animal Crossing or Metroid Prime 4 or anything like that. It was pretty much all Smash. I was surprised about the Super Mario Party reveal, but then the rest was Smash. And the other things I didn't really care too much about. I enjoyed Let's Go Pikachu and Let's Go Eevee. That game looks like fun. But other than that, I didn't really care. And the Smash got to be a little bit much after a little while. But, I mean, it's cool that they're doing a lot with Smash Bros. Ultimate, and I'm definitely buying it. It's just, I wish that we would see some more games from Nintendo. But we didn't. Nothing you can do about that now. So, with that, the E3 press conferences are over. Completely done. Now we have to wait till next year for more E3 press conferences. If you like this video, drop a like, comment, subscribe, tell your friends. You know the spiel. And this whole playlist has E3 2018 stuff, all the press conferences, the walkthroughs, everything. If you love E3 2018 so much, you need to watch everything. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I will see you in